Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.3 Beta 1. This is available to developers and hopefully soon to public beta testers. Apple released this on a Friday, which is rare, and late in the day, so after 4 p.m. Eastern time. So based off of that, you may not have a public beta until next week at some point, or maybe even later. Hopefully it's released by the time of this video. Now as you can see, this came in at 5.5 gigabytes, that's on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it was over 5 gigabytes on all the devices as you have here, from the iPhone XR, the iPhone 11, and iPhone 6S Plus. And anytime you go from a beta to a public version or from a public version to a beta, you generally have to install the whole update and it just overwrites the OS, and that's why they're so large. Now, along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15.3 Beta 1 that I have on the 12.9 inch iPad Pro from 2021, as well as WatchOS 8.4 Beta 1, tvOS 15.3 Beta 1, and yesterday, macOS Monterey 12.2 Beta 1. So all of those are available now. Now, as far as new changes and updates, well, let's first take a look at the build number, and then we'll talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go to general, then about. Now, as you can see, the build number is 19D5026G, and this particular build does include a few small changes and updates. And the first update is to the modem build, or the modem firmware itself. Now, the odd thing about this is the modem firmware is newer, but it's actually an older version than we had with iOS 15.2. So with iOS 15.2, we had 1.32.09 on the 13 Pro Max. Now we have 1.31.01. It's a modem update. I haven't really noticed any difference with connectivity between 5G and 5G UC, but there is a modem update. So if you're concerned about that, you may want to stay off of this update. And we'll talk more about that in a moment. Now, as far as new features, well, there's a slight change within the podcasts app. So if we go into podcasts, first we'll go into podcasts on 15.2. And then we'll go on 15.3. And you can see once you're in your library and you go to your latest episodes, if you have the option toggled to hide played episodes, you'll get this when all of them have been played. And you'll see prior to this, it said no latest episodes. The latest episodes from the shows you follow will appear here. Now it says all caught up, all your latest episodes are played and hidden by a filter. So that's been updated in 15.3 Beta 1. Also, there's some updates for the child safety feature as far as some wording goes. Now, quite a few people were concerned about this, but this is not the same thing as CSAM. In fact, Apple has removed all of the references to CSAM off their website where they talked about it before. It seems they've done that. It's delayed indefinitely. And so we may or may not ever see that again. However, child safety is here, and that's done on device and warns a child that's under 13 if there's an issue with maybe a photo that was sent to them in messages, or they're searching and see an image that may not be appropriate for their age. Now, the nice thing is there's actually a toggle for this that was found in 15.2, but I wanted to share it with you since I didn't mention that. If you go to your settings and you go under settings, and then you go down to screen time and then select a child, the child has to be the appropriate age. If you scroll down after selecting the child under 13, you'll see it says communication safety. Tap on this and you can now turn it on or off, whatever you prefer. And you'll see it says messages can detect photos before they're sent or viewed on your child's device and provide guidance. So some of the wording has changed when they actually see a photo that's blurred out. And prior to this, it would say this content could be sensitive to view. Are you sure? Now it says this content could be sensitive to view. Are you sure you want to view it? So it's just trying to clarify that for a child. So they'll continue to update that, I think, in the future. Also, there's some additional references to AirPods 3 if you're pairing them for the first time, just some small wording changes throughout. There's not a whole lot in here. Also, Apple's digital ID is not present yet in this as well. So those things could be coming in the future. Typically with a beta 1, there's not a huge change throughout. However, as far as resolved issues and known issues, Apple, again, has not said a single thing in their notes. It says there's no new notes. Now, they've definitely changed some things, probably fixed some bugs. And the first thing I noticed is the overall smoothness of the display. This makes a lot of sense since in macOS 12.2 betas that they released, it seems very smooth with ProMotion when you go into Safari, where it was previously not as fast. Now it seems very smooth throughout iOS as well. I noticed that immediately after installing it, just scrolling through different things within iOS seemed to be very, very fast. So I'm not having any issues whatsoever, and it seems to be like it's much better than it was before. Now, third-party apps will still need to enable that though in order for ProMotion to work if you have it enabled. Also, another thing I noticed is AirDrop seems to be much faster. It was almost broken for some people in 15.2 or just took a while. Now it's very quick going from one device to another as I transferred the wallpaper here from one to the other, typically when I'm doing these videos, and it was very fast as far as that goes. Also, storage seems to load quickly for most people. So if we go into settings, go to general, then iPhone storage, you'll see it loaded very quickly for me. I really haven't had any issues with this when I went and tested it. If I do the same thing on my 13 Pro Max, we'll go into iPhone storage there, give it just a moment. It will take a moment initially, but it seems to load much more quickly this time around. So it's calculating size, and sometimes it can take 30 seconds or so, and there we go, it loaded. So it seems to be faster, and it's accurate now in loading everything. It even just loaded system data and iOS. So much better than before. As far as anything on iPadOS 15.5 Beta 1, again, it seems very smooth. Apple definitely has been working on ProMotion, and I think they're improving it. But I haven't really found anything specific to iPadOS that seems to be new in this update. So they keep working on that, and it seems to be very fast. No problems there. Also, with older devices, performance seems to be good. And again, typically I go into Minecraft to measure this. I'll go into Minecraft, see how quickly it loads, and compare it to what we had before. And you'll see on the oldest device, the 6S Plus here, it loaded very quick. In fact, I would say that's faster than iOS 15.2 this time around. Things are much faster as far as that goes, and I think they're optimizing performance overall. So it seems to be pretty good. Now we'll take a look at benchmarks in a moment, but first I wanted to talk about battery life. Battery life seemed to be pretty good on 15.2, but let's take a look at battery life here. You'll see my battery health is at 100% on this device, and if we look at the last 10 days, it's pretty good depending on the day. You'll see yesterday I had a lot of screen off time, 4 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, 8 hours and 29 minutes of screen off time. However, this might be a bug from either today with Siri or something else, as it's saying it's using 11% of my battery. I haven't really used Siri today, so something's going on there, but I had 8 hours and 29 minutes of screen off time and used about 70% of my battery. The day before, 3 hours and 25 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 50 minutes of screen off time. So I would expect battery to probably get a little bit better as Apple continues to optimize things when it comes to performance and more, but it will take a few days to know this and measure it for sure. Now let's take a look at the benchmark. So I did run Geekbench on all of these, and you saw it just flash on the display there. Single core is 1,726, where multi-core is 4,753. This is actually quite good compared to the release candidate and final version. As you can see here, it's actually a little bit faster for both single and multi-core. And I ran this right after installing the update. So generally, this is quite good, and I expect it to improve a little bit. Now let's take a look at all of these devices. Now keep in mind, I ran this right after installing the update on all of the devices here, but from left to right, we have the 12.9-inch iPad Pro from 2021, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus, then the iPhone 11, then the iPhone 13 Pro Max. And again, this is just a reference to see if your devices are basically around the same speed, but I would expect them to increase a little bit over the next few days. Now, another thing I wanted to note is the phone was not getting warm at all, even after running Geekbench, which is a little bit unusual. So it seems that Apple has optimized performance a little bit better, and I think that's noticeable in the interface as well, like I mentioned already. Now that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.3 Beta 1? And I would typically say absolutely not, unless you want to beta test something. If you're trying to fix an issue, then no. But if you want to try the betas out and you have a secondary device, or you have a backup and you can restore using iTunes or Finder on a Mac, then definitely you could try it out. But just make sure you have a backup before. Now, as far as the next release, Apple released last year iOS 14.4 Beta 1 on December 16th. They released Beta 2 in January on the 13th. So at this point, Beta 2 could be well into January at that point. So we might not see it until maybe the second or third week of January, where Apple typically has a break for the holidays and Christmas and New Year's throughout the end of the month and the beginning of January. So at this point, we may not see Beta 2 until later on. It's possible we could see it earlier, or Apple could change it up. But based on what they've done last year, that seems more likely. So at this point, if you're trying out betas, you may not want to try this one just because you won't see a beta 2 for quite some time based off of that. But maybe we'll see one earlier if Apple changes it up a little bit. Now, if I find anything else in this update, I'll mention it in a different video a little bit later on. And if you've found anything, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.